Jai Hind, dear students. Today we will read an interesting excerpt which is taken from the book Encounter with Animals written by Gerald Durrell. Before I begin, let's know about anteaters. Anteaters are edentate animals. They have no teeth, but their long tongues are more than sufficient to lap up the 35,000 ants and termites they swallow whole each day. It is covered in grayish brown fur with white front legs, black stripes running from its chest to its back, and a bushy tail. Giant anteaters can be found throughout South and Central America. The giant anteaters uses its sharp claws to tear an opening into an anthill and put its long snout, sticky saliva, and efficient tongue to work. Gerald Durrell. Gerald Durrell was born in 1925. He was a British zookeeper, environmentalist, conservationist, author, and television presenter. He was born in Jamshedpur and always said that his lifelong love of animals began with his first visit to a zoo in India. This piece is from his book Encounter with Animals. Some of his other books are My Family and Other Animals and Birds, Beast and Relatives. So children, now it's time to read the passage. Let's begin. A villager wandered into our camp carrying a sack. Opening the sack, he pulled out the most delightful baby animal I had ever seen. She was a young giant anteater about 1 week old. She was about the size of a corgi. With her black, ash-grey and white fur, a long slender snout and a pair of tiny eyes. The man said he had found her wandering about in the forest. He thought her mother had been killed by a jaguar. I paid him and thus became a father to one of the most charming children I have ever met. So children, in this passage, the author has told where did he get the anteater from. He has also described the physical features of the anteater. Now let's read the next passage. The first difficulty came almost at once. We had a baby's feeding bottle, and after a search of the whole village, we discovered one teat, very old and unhygienic in appearance. After one or two attempts, the baby took to the bottle, but feeding her was a painful performance. Young anteaters cling to their mother's back, and she insisted on climbing on one of us nearly the whole time. Her claws were about 3 inches long and she had a very strong grip. During meals, she clasped your leg affectionately with 3 paws. With her remaining paw, she held your finger and squeezed it hard at intervals. She was convinced that this would increase the flow of milk from the bottle. So children, in this passage, the author describes what difficulties he faced while feeding the model baby anteater. So now let's read the next one. For the first few days, I carried her about with me. She liked to lie across the back of my neck, her long nose hanging down one side of me and her long tail down the other like a fur collar. Every time I moved, she would tighten her grip in a panic, and this was painful. After she had ruined my 4th shirt, I decided that she would have to cling to something else, so I filled a sack full of straw and introduced her to that. She accepted it without any fuss and would lie in her cage, clutching it happily. We had already named her Sarah, and now, because of this habit of sack clutching, we gave her a surname, and so she became known as Sarah Hugger Sack. Sarah was a model baby. Between feeds, she lay quietly on her sack, yawning and showing a sticky pink-gray tongue about 12 inches long. At feeding time, she would suck the teat on her bottle so vigorously that it soon changed from red to pale pink. The hole at the end of it became about the size of a matchstick, and the whole thing drooped steadily from the neck of the bottle. Children, in this passage, we came to know that how did Sarah got a name, Sarah Hugger Sack. And we also came to know that how attached she was to her teat. Now let's read the next passage. When we left Paraguay, Sarah slept peacefully throughout the flight, lying on my wife's lap and snoring gently, occasionally blowing a few bubbles of sticky saliva out of her nose. On arriving in Buenos Aires, our first thought was to give Sarah a treat. We would buy her a nice new shiny teat. We went to a lot of trouble selecting one exactly the right size, shape and color, put it on the bottle and presented it to Sarah. She was outraged. She honked wildly at the mere thought of a new teat and sent the bottle flying with a well-directed blow from her paw. She calmed down and started to feed only after we put back the old teat on the bottle. She clung to it ever after months after her arrival in England. She would not be parted from it. So children, in this passage, the author describes that how attached Sarah was to her teat and how did she react when she was given a new teat. So children, I hope you would have enjoyed reading this tale. In this unit is a lovely tale of the author's experience of bringing up an anteater in his house. He talks about its habits and behavior in detail. The story is absolutely engaging and the narrative style is informal. So children, just read this story, underline the difficult words and come up with the queries. Thank you and Jai Hind.